I realized after making all of these chapters and going through and listening to them again, that I actually needed to do a preface to the introduction. I'm sort of acting as a peculiar childbirth historian so that people might understand how we got here. The present always comes from the past and decisions that are made in generations before us. We do what we do because that's what we know what to do. And when we know better, we do better. And my hope is that this series will help New Zealand midwives recognize that what's happening now was inevitable because of what happened in the past. And it can easily change, because when we know how to do better, then we do better. My guess is that 90% of New Zealand midwives and pregnant families today were not born when I gave birth in 1970 under one childbirth trend, nor were they born when I gave birth last in 1982 under another childbirth trend. The U.S. has played a huge part in the global childbirth conversation, not because it's a better country with better ideas. It's just that it's an incredibly big country with a huge number of people and no ability to coordinate on a country level because we have 50 states all doing their own thing. So something like Parent Center could never have developed in the United States. Something like NOSCOM could never develop in the United States. My guess also is that 99.9% of midwives and women and men would have little knowledge of the U.S. history of childbirth from the 50s to the 1980s when it became global in the conversation. And that global conversation led to the New Zealand midwifery model. And I would suspect that nobody has compared the New Zealand history to the U.S. history or to any other country's history. And I suspect that 99.999% of all midwives and women and men would not know that H.A. Brandt did an evolutionary childbirth study at National Women's in 1961. And I would even go further to suspect that 90% of women and men in New Zealand who are pregnant have little interest in how we got here and what we might do about it. I had the accidental privilege of giving birth between two remarkable trends. I lived through, saw, and discussed the two pathways that opened up coming from the exact same source. And I happened to be privileged to start working with hundreds of expectant families at this time of change between one childbirth trend and the other. What happened to those two pathways that opened up when I gave birth in 1970 had only become one pathway in 1982 when I gave birth last, and that pathway is what led to today. I've heard and I've listened to and I've watched how this one pathway led to the midwifery model in New Zealand today. And that other pathway was seen, it was observed, it was commented on in the United States and in Brandt's study, but it was not recognized, even though its success was phenomenal, as is shown in Brandt's study. And I despaired when the source reason for the two paths to develop was actively dismissed rather than encouraged to grow and evolve along with this new trend. I could see, hear, and discuss why that one path was always going to lead to a weak partnership model. It was a weak model to begin with. The prototype of the midwifery partnership model that I saw in the 70s and the 80s, the midwives were already exhausted. They were doing too much of the work, taking on too much of the responsibility, giving so much of their time and so much of their energy, and expecting so little of the expectant family, the birthing woman and her other. We can love what we do, and yet do it in a dysfunctional manner. And that can drive us to consider how to do what we love in a more functional manner. It was obvious how you could bring those two pathways together so that there could be an incredibly strong midwifery partnership in any country or in any state. This is actually not complex. New Zealand midwives are already serving almost all pregnant women. And this is a tiny tweak that is so easy to implement, yet it requires knowledge, to understand the reasons for doing it, a commitment to doing it, and a broader, more inclusive approach to expectant families. The results will be much bigger and better than what Brandt talked about and the U.S. experience, because there is a political and social structure already in place. Keep in mind, we do what we do because we know how to do it. And when we know better, we do better.